Mr. Mize is here, and I am going to go over with you today limits. Limits is kind of a calculus thing, but you know what? Pre-calculus, we often talk about limits in pre-calculus because that is what we're going to do in calculus. So, of course, pre-calculus means pre-calculus. We're getting ready for calculus, so let's go over limits. So in this video, I'm really just going to give you an idea of what a limit is, kind of like the basic concept, and then look at something called one-sided limits, and that's pretty much it, okay? So we'll look at a couple examples. So a limit, if you think of limit in terms of like a, you know, like the English language would say, you know, there's no limits on what I can do. The limit is this, you know, I have no limits, meaning, there's nothing that could stop me. I look like a rapper or something, but what I'm trying to say is that a limit is something that stops, right? If you have a limit, that's like the most you can do, okay? So it's kind of that idea when we talk about the limit not existing. But for now, what we're really looking at is whether or not, or a number that we're getting closer and closer and closer to. So a limit is a number that we're getting closer and closer and closer to. So let's take a look at what I mean. Now it's new notation for you guys. So let's write it out, and then I'll write it in words so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so we have the limit, L-I-M, and right underneath we have x equals, I'll put a, an f of x, this is part of it, it's like inside the limit, equals some number L, okay? So how we say this is we say the limit as x approaches a of f of x is equal to L. All right, so that's how you say this. The limit as x approaches a, as x gets closer and closer and closer to a of f of x is equal to L. So here's what we're talking about, guys. What we're trying to do is we're trying to determine what the y value is as x gets closer to whatever that a value is. So we're looking at the graph, we're kind of like traveling along the graph, and we're looking to see what is that y value, what are we getting closer and closer to y as x gets closer and closer to a. So let's take a look at an example. So what I mean is, let's say we want the limit as x approaches 5 of f of x, and I'm going to draw the function right now. Actually, let's go with 2 because I have a small grid here. Okay, so let's say I have this function that looks like this. All right, it's just some curve, y equals f of x. All right, so now what I'm looking at is as x gets closer and closer and closer and closer and closer and closer to 2, like it's 2 point, like from this side I'm going this way, it's 2.1, you know, 2.001, 2.0001, 2.000001, as I get closer and closer. So as x goes to 2, gets closer and closer, what is the y value approaching on that graph? Okay, as you can see, the y value, as I get closer to 2 here, the y value is getting closer and closer to 2. Okay, so for this graph, the closer and closer x gets to 2, the closer and closer y gets to 2, so my limit is going to be 2. All right, so that's an example of a limit, what a limit looks like. Let's say that right here, I had an open circle. So there, the function doesn't exist at 2. Well, with limits, it doesn't matter if there's a point there or not. It's as we get closer and closer and closer to 2, what does y get closer and closer and closer also? So we're not talking about what is y equal to. We want to know what y is getting closer to. So this answer would be the same for this picture, because we're getting closer to that number, not exact. It doesn't have to be on that number. In fact, I can even have it like a dot up here where the function is equal to that up there. It's not what f is equal to, It's what f is getting closer to, okay? So that's the basic idea of a limit. And what I'll show you here is an example, what we call a one-sided limit in the next example. And we'll do like a whole example and look at some limits, okay? So we'll be right back. All right, back here, I got a lot of stuff written on this board, guys, a lot of stuff. And this is about limits. This is actually about one-sided limits now. Now, what a one-sided limit is we're actually, when I showed you on the, just in the previous example, we talked about the limit as something gets closer and closer and closer, what is y value approaching? Now, if we think about it, if we're going on a graph, we have to approach from, with this, got one point here, right? We got one point right here. We got to approach this point from both sides. We can't just approach this way. We got to approach this way too and see if as we approach both ways, what is that y value approach? So we call those one-sided limits. And right here, I've got the basic idea property of a one-sided limit. Actually, let me step back for just a second over here. So the way we write that is the limit as x approaches a, we write a little plus right above the a, and that little plus means from the right. So you can kind of think of it as I'm coming from the right, from the more positive number. So I'm coming this way on the graph. If I put a little minus, a little negative right above the A, that's from the left. That means I'm coming from the left, all right? This way. So we'll take a look at these examples. This is example, this is practice, and I'll go over both of them. One thing you got to remember, though, is that if in order for a limit to exist, the whole limit, limit as x approaches A, in order for it to exist and hit L, the limit from the right must be equal to the limit from the left, and we'll see that as an example right now. Okay, so let's take a look at what I'm talking about, shall we? We shall. All right, so we've got all these limits here, and just, you know, I know this is in black, I'm gonna put a little squiggly mark here. This is f of x, okay, this is y equals f of x, and this is y equals g of x, so that you know which one goes with which. Okay, so the limit as x approaches negative 2 from the left of g of x. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go over here, and here's negative 2, okay? This is always an x value. And I'm going to approach negative 2 from the left, so I'm coming from this side. Okay, so I'm going to go on this graph, and I'm going to come from the left, I'm going to keep going. And what is the y value approach as x gets closer to negative 2? The y value approaches, well, draw this here, okay? We're gonna say that's, so we get an equal amount here. We're gonna say this approaches a y value of 2. Okay, so that approaches a y value of 2. As I approach negative 2 from the right, that's this side. So I'm getting from close values of negative 2, so I'm really close, okay? I'm traveling along this, and I'm getting really close to negative 2 from the right. My y value is gonna approach 3. Well, these two are different. So the limit as x approaches negative 2 total, since the left and the right are not the same, this is, does not exist. Okay, so this limit does not exist. We can also write it, in my case, I'll let you write it as dne, but does not exist, okay? So let's take a look at this side. This side's a little different right here for g of x. The limit as x approaches negative or positive 2 from the left, so this way, from the left, my y value is going to be 1. From the right, as I approach that from the right, my y value is going to be positive 1. Well, since both of them are equal, the limit is equal. Bam! Right there. See, it's really not that bad, guys. Left, right. Actually, it's right, left, right? All right. Switch the name. All right, so why don't you try this practice and then I'll come back and we'll work it together, okay? So 1 second. Okay, so let's go and work this guy out. So the limit as x approaches negative 4. Now it's not left or right, so we got to approach from both directions. As negative 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. The limit as x approaches negative 4, so as we get closer and closer on this side, what is the y value approach? It looks like, I should have drawn that a little bit better, but it looks like 3. Okay, what about x approaches negative 2? Oh, there's a little dot there, so we've got to be careful, because remember, if that function is defined there. So f of negative 2 is going to be 1, negative 1, right? But we don't care what it's defined, we care about where it's going, what it's getting closer to. So x gets closer to negative 2. As x gets closer to negative 2 from the left, this is from the left. From the left, I'm getting closer to negative 3 on my y. So that's negative 3. I'm also getting closer to negative 3 coming from the right. Since I'm coming from the right and I'm coming from the left and they're both equal, the limit, this should not be a negative, this should be, sorry guys, I meant to say limit as x approaches negative 2. Let's look at this one. The limit as x approaches 2, okay, here's x equals 2. As I approach 2 from the right, so as I come this way, going closer from the right, my y value is going to be 1. As I approach 2 from the left, my y value is going to be 3. So what is the limit as x approaches 2? Does not exist. And if you like Mean Girls, you remember that little line, the limit does not exist. Bam, calculus, all right? In this case, this is for my pre-calc class. There you go. Limits, one side limits, boom!